Hello, this is Professor Kitch. Welcome to this webcast, which is the second of two on the section 10.5. This webcast covers soil compressibility parameters. After this webcast, you should be able to define the compression index, recompression index, compression ratio, and recompression ratio, and you should be able to compute these parameters given lab test data. We discussed in the previous module that we can plot consolidation test data as either void ratio versus log of effective stress or strain versus log of effective stress. We'll first look at the void ratio versus log of effective stress plot. The compression curve in this plot starts at the initial void ratio E0 and follows the recompression inversion curves to the final void ratio E sub F. It's important to note that the void ratio decreases from E0 to E sub F. For computation purposes, we have placed 2 points on the virgin curve, A and B, and 2 points on the recompression curve, C and D. The slope of the compression curve is a measure of compressibility. The steeper the curve, the greater the compressibility. That's why the virgin curve is steeper than the recompression curve. The slope of the virgin curve per log cycle is called the compression index and denoted C sub C. By definition, this is the change in void ratio per change in the log of effective stress. The definition contains a negative sign because the void ratio decreases as the soil compresses, and we want a positive value of C sub C to represent a positive compression. Using points A and B to compute C sub C as the slope of the virgin curve, C sub C is the void ratio at A minus the void ratio at B divided by the log of the effective stress at B minus the log of the effective stress at A. We use E sub A minus E sub B in the numerator rather than the other way around to account for the negative sign. Since the log of B minus the log of A is equal to the log of B over A, we can rewrite the equation for the compression index as E sub A minus E sub B over the log of the effective stress at B divided by the effective stress at A. The recompression index is formulated in the same fashion as the compression index. Using points C and D, the recompression index is E sub C minus E sub D divided by the log of the effective vertical stress at D over the log of the effective vertical stress at C. If we use the method of plotting strain versus the log of effective stress, which is the more common method, the compression curve starts at a vertical strain of 0 and ends at a final vertical strain of epsilon ZF. In this formulation, the slope of the virgin curve is called the compression ratio and equal to C sub C over 1 plus E naught. And we compute the compression ratio as the vertical strain at B minus the vertical strain at A divided by the log of the ratio of the vertical effective stress at B over the vertical effective stress at A. Since the strain is increasing from epsilon Z equals 0 at the start to epsilon ZF at the end, we don't need a negative sign, so the numerator in the compression ratio is epsilon z at B minus epsilon z at A. This is opposite the way we computed the numerator in the compression index, where we subtracted the void ratio at B from the void ratio at A. The recompression ratio is then the recompression index divided by 1 plus E naught. And using the points D and C, computed as epsilon z at D minus epsilon z at C, divided by the log of the ratio of the vertical effective stress at D over the vertical effective stress at C. All we're doing in these last two slides is computing the slope of the recompression and virgin curves, but we have to do it in semi-log space. I'll do a quick example and show you a trick to make this computation very simple. In this case, we're using the more common form with the vertical strain as a function of the log of effective stress, and we'll be computing the compression and recompression ratios. It's easiest to compute the slopes of the two lines over a full log cycle, so we'll start off by drawing two vertical lines one log cycle apart. We'll choose to draw the lines at an effective stress of 100 and 1000. We could have picked any 2 points one log cycle apart, such as 5 and 500, or 200 and 2000. We then extend the virgin curve so it intersects both vertical lines. And we'll compute the slope of the virgin curve where it intersects the two vertical lines at points A and B. At B, the strain is 0.202, and at A, it's 0.030. The compression ratio is then 0.202 minus 0.030 divided by the log of 1000 over 100, which is 0.202 minus 0.030 over the log of 10. But the log of 10 is simply 1, so the compression ratio is simply 0.202 minus 0.030. So this is the trick. If you compute the slope using points that are one log cycle apart, the slope will simply be the difference between the two strain values, or in this case, 0.172. The recompression ratio is computed in a similar fashion. In this case, we extend the recompression curve until it intersects the two vertical lines. The recompression curve intersects these two lines at strains of 0.097 and 0.042. And the recompression index is simply 0.097 minus 0.042, or 0.053. Notice that both indices are dimensionless, so we don't need to know the units of effective stress. That's all there is to it. It's really quite simple, especially if you use the trick of picking points that are a log cycle apart. It's always good to check our computations to see if they seem reasonable. We have a few ways to do this. From Kohaui and Main's EPRI report on estimating soil properties, we can use these two correlations between plasticity index and the compression and recompression indices. Most soils will lie within 50% of the values computed from these correlations, so if you compute a value outside this range, you should check your numbers and see if the computations are correct. Table 10.2 of your text provides a qualitative description of the ranges of compression or recompression ratios. It's also useful for checking computed values. Well, that's all there is for this webcast, so let's summarize. We use the parameters C sub C and C sub R, or C sub C over 1 plus E naught and C sub R over 1 plus E naught, to represent the compressibility of soil in our semi-logarithmic stress strain space. C sub C and C sub R are used if we plot by void ratio, and C sub C over 1 plus E naught and C sub R over 1 plus E naught are used if we plot by vertical strain. Don't mix the two up or your answers will be wrong. We can make our job easier by picking points on the curves that are one log cycle apart, since the log of 10 is equal to 1 and the number 1 is our friend. It's just another amigo.